Hello and welcome. In this tutorial, I would like to show you how you can animate such a slide, how you can go over the animation to make a video out of it, and your final result would be a 10 second video with this object animating nicely in. So I will select everything and see what I have. Okay, I have a line here, text, text, and another line. I also have a background, and this is a vignette, this is a photograph, but we do not want to touch that. You could also go to Home, select, and open up the selection pane to see everything you have. I see the rectangle is the background, this is the image, so I only need to work with those four things. Okay, if you have trouble selecting them, you can select them here. So first, those two lines, with my Control key, I can select both lines or I can select them here, and go to animations and think about my first animation. And if you don't have any idea, you will never go wrong, of course, with fade or fly-in, but you can go to Add Animation, More Entrance Effects, and you can preview the effects on the actual object. Diamond, fly-in, no. This seems interesting, checkerboard, but I also know that straight lines go very well along with stripes. So I'll select stripes here, and you see, we have a really nice animation like that, and I think I'll stay with it. Now once I'm in the animations, I would go to my animation pane to see what I have here. Of course, I want to right click and select with previews so they both start automatically. Now I'll select the first one, and the first one should go from left to bottom. So I'll go to my effect options and go right down. Okay, like that. Because I want the animation to kind of follow such a flow. Now the text, then, and then this. Maybe the second line as well, or the opposite direction, so it's a bit more interesting. Okay, I'll put it here and I'll put it a bit later, because the second one will come later. Now the text, and I'll show you a great trick here, because the text can be animated with the fade option, with the fade animation, but you can double click here, you can go to effect, and something that not everyone uses but is amazingly good and it's underused definitely in PowerPoint, is to go to animate text. And instead of having all at once, like this object animating fade in, you can have by word or by letter. By word, the percent delay between words, maybe let's make it a bit less, like 5%, so the text will appear really quick. And this is the beautiful animation that you get. Now, of course, you would need to make this animation longer. So I'll go right click with previews. I place them between the lines because I want this line to appear, then this text to fade in, and then the last line to appear. And the duration can be about 3 seconds, maybe a bit delayed. Now the straight connector as well delayed. Let us now preview the slide. Okay, a bit too slow, I don't like it. Let's make it less in duration, less in delay. Okay, the delay can stay here. Okay, this starts to look okay. Maybe even a bit less of the duration. Sorry that I'm tinkering so much about the duration. Now the text. The text could be as well animated, like a simple fade in, right click with previous, put it here, put it later, so it will appear at the end of this animation. Maybe I make it a bit longer, a bit earlier, or even here in the straight connector. Go a bit backwards, and this is about it when it comes to animating this object, this poster. So the entire animation, as you see here on the bottom, takes about 3 seconds. We can also count that 2.75 and half a second of duration makes it 3.25 seconds. Okay, play from. Okay, the straight connector comes in too late, but basically this is how the entire design could look like. Let's extend the duration. And once you have that ready, and you would like to make a video out of it, a 10 second video, you go to transitions, because you need to determine how long this slide should play on the screen. Instead of on mouse click, I'll select after, and I'll select after 10 seconds. So regardless of the animations, the animations will end in 3 seconds, and the slide will play it for a further 7 seconds to have a total of 10 seconds before the video ends. So I'll select File, Export, Create a Video, I'll select Create a Video, I'll export this, I'll save this, and I'll show you the final result. 10 seconds long and perfect. Oh, sorry, this screen is a bit too big. we have the animation, it's placed through, and the entire video has 10 seconds, so it's perfect for posting anywhere. This is how you can approach animating a slide, creating a video out of it, and playing around with the timings.